Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. One thing about Scripture, it just drops it like a ton of lead right on you. So absolute. Why? I mean, come on, John. Give us a little slack here. Can I love some things in the world just a little? Why does it seem like so often Scripture just... I mean, if anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Period. You know why? You know why I have to believe that? Because just like with the rest of John, if you come along and you say you know him and you don't keep his commandments, bang! Again, just boom, hit you with a ton of lead. You're a liar. Mm. Brethren, the reality is this. It's like Paul Washer said before. If you came in this door right now and you told us you just got hit by an 18-wheeler and you look just like you all look right now, we'd all say you're lying to us. I don't think that's the basic weight of the matter. He's saying, look, when you're born again and when you're indwelt by the Spirit of God, it is so radical and it so produces a love for God and a hate for this world that it is so stark, it is so real, it is so obvious that is there a battle? Well, yes, there's a battle because obviously we've got to wage war against these anti-soul forces, one of which is the world that we're not to be conformed to, we're not to love it. And so there is this fight not to do it, but it is so real and it is so... Brethren, it isn't the kind of thing where you live your life in love with the world all the time and you're trying to get out the magnifying glass and stare and look and strain and squint to figure out if you're a Christian or not. The truth is, this is so obvious when it happens to somebody's life. It takes them where they're in this course and it totally spins them around so obviously that, brethren, I've seen it. I've seen this happen to people. The worldliness just starts to fall off one after another. It falls off. And I'll tell you this, people that have supposedly had this amazing transformation happen in their life and conversion, and all of a sudden 2, 3, 4, 5 years down the road, the worldliness just hasn't fallen off. Brethren, there's no truth to it. Mm-hmm. You say, well, you can't say that. You're judging. I can say that because God's Word says that. If that person shows by a continuous ongoing lifestyle that they're in love with the world, they do not love God. They are those adulteresses and adulterers that James is dealing with, and they're at enmity with God. Lay it down. Hands down, folks. Brethren, yes, there's a battle. I don't doubt that. But this is a battle for life and death. And that's what we're told here.